John here with CRMD, and today we're looking at Picklist Fields. I've been requested a lot recently to help clients clean up their data. We've had a lot of clients who have just erroneous field values, and they really want to drill down and make sure that they're all consistent. So a great way to do that is with Picklist Fields. Essentially, you're having a field, and the only values you can choose for that field are predefined in your Picklist values. So looking at this list here, it helps simplify data, like we talked about. They guide users to certain values, so the ones that you already predefined in your setup for this field. And they're not great for long entries, though. So for instance, you probably don't want to put addresses in there, anything that's going to be a long value. It's really just designed for short values that you can put in there. So the example that Salesforce gives in their trailhead is using the example of cookie. So cookie would be your field name. And then your values would be different types of cookies. You have sugar cookie, chocolate chip, oatmeal, and being able to pick from one of those instead of your users being able to manually enter the data. So for this pick list, for the cookie value, I would click a cookie and select sugar cookie, and that would be the only value I could pick for that.
So we are now in the home screen of Lightning in Salesforce, and we are going to go into setup to look at our pick list field. So clicking on setup, in the quick find box at the top, I want to type in object, and we're going to create a pick list on the lead object. So I'm gonna click into object manager, and I'm going to look for lead here. So I find it right here and click into lead. And from this screen, I need to find the fields and relationships button, click there. And these are all my fields that are currently in the system that I'm working in. So I want to create a new field, and I'm going to click on this button here called new, clicking in, and you can see I have all these different types of fields I can choose from. I want to pick pick list, so I pick on the, I select the pick list here and click next, and the field label I'm going to just write cookie, going with our example that we talked about on the board. And I can use a global pick list value set. I haven't created one of those yet, so I'm going to select the values here and enter them in manually. So I'm just going to write them in: chocolate chip, sugar cookie, and I think the other one I had up there was oatmeal. So I'm just going to write those in. I could write a description if I wanted to, a help text for my other users if I wanted them to see what this field is actually for. For this example, I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to click right through. And I just wanted to look one more thing on this field that could be useful for you. You can use the use first value as default value if you wanted to. I could select that. I could also deselect this one option here that says restrict pick list to the values defined in this value set. That one is kind of important if you wanted to allow your users to enter values in that were not already predefined. You could deselect that. I only want my users to pick from these three options, so I'm going to leave that checked, and I'm going to click next. And this is where I can select the visibility of this field. So I'm just going to leave this as standard, what's already out of the box here, and I'll click next. And this is where I can decide which page layouts this is going to appear on. So in my instance, I have four different page layouts: lead layout, support layout, sales layout, and marketing layout. I'm going to have this field on every one of those, so I'm going to click save. And now if I go to one of my objects in the lead, if I go to one of my records, I should see this field. So I'm going to click over to that, and I'm going to click into leads. And I'm going to select all open leads so I can find a record to use as an example. Clicking in there, and that field should appear on my details page, which is right here. And I can see that I have cookie here. So if I click on that, those are my options. I have chocolate chip, sugar cookie, or oatmeal. I'm going to select oatmeal and click save. And now it's selected. So that's how you add a pick list value. And if I ever wanted to update that pick list, so say I wanted to add an additional cookie at some point, I do the same approach that I did before, except this time, instead of creating it, I'm just going to edit that field and add those additional values in, or take away values if I wanted to, if I only wanted certain values to choose from. But that's the benefits of a pick list field and what you can do with it. Thanks.